about desertification. So what is desertification? What are its causes? And what all are the action plans that authorities has been made? So we will look through it. Desertification. Here you can see an image of barren area onto which you can see cracks. Okay, these all are the causes of land degradation. So land degradation is having lot of effect on the ecosystem or our biodiversity. This barren area has been created because of land degradation, and desertification is the main cause. So we need to transform, see the transformation, or you can see in reverse and forward time. Here you can see one side is being desert and another side is being with the flourished one. So desertification, scientific versus political realities. We know there are a lot of understanding for desertification and its topic. So desertification is a land degradation that can result in dry lands. So desertification is a major concept that has been discussed by UNCCD. It is an organization, World Organization, UN Convention to Combat Desertification. See, for that an organization is there. It plays an important role in the sustainable land use and food production. Sustainable land use and food production. So I know this is clear for you. Now, you should understand some of the points. Desertification is an environmental issue, right? Desertification is an environmental issue. So a problem that we all facing is because of land degradation, desertification is a fact. So there are millions of hectares of land that is being affected or decrease in productivity due to desertification. So GIS, remote sensing data, everything gives an idea on this picture. So there is many organization that we already discussed is United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. It claims that 200 million of hectares are being annually lost. How much? 12 million. Okay, 12 million hectares of land are annually lost. So what will be the condition? So 1.2 billion people are inhabiting dry areas in 110 countries. So is it a myth? That is a question. Is it a myth? Maybe. Okay, but it is a reality. Why we say like that? It is a reality that we are facing in our arena. Many policies are being adopted by agriculture and food production in this dry areas. Okay, for that there is a sustainable development goal 15, sustainable development goal 15, which what does it takes, what does it includes, or what does it explain to us? Combating desertification as an important target by using terrestrial agrosystem, sustainable terrestrial agrosystem, that you have to put forward. So there are many articles or peer-reviewed publications based on this desertification were being presented, right? If you see the history from 1920s to 1930, you can observe this kind of conditions. So, and it again grows 1950s to 60 and came 1970, and 1977 this kind of organization was being put forward by at Nairobi, right? So UNCOD, what is UN Conference on Desertification, were being organized, and many action plans were made to combat this desertification. So the people focused on those dry areas, arid, semi-arids, dry, sub-humid, dry lands. Okay, so the and not on this tropical area, but these areas were being more focused. These areas are being more focused. See the condition. See the condition of the land, sand dunes formation. See the condition of land. So this is a long-lasting process. Possibly irreversible desert-like condition is being observed. Irreversible desert-like stage is being observed. Okay. So that is the main understanding that you should know. In this Rio de Janeiro, in that summit also, Earth Summit, all of you know this Earth Summit at this place, Rio de Janeiro. Here again they focused or defined the certification as land degradation in semi-arid and arid and dry sub-humid areas. Okay, so there will be prolonged, because prolonged conditions of drought and flood because of human activities and climatic variations, right? We are facing that. Because of this severe drought, or sometimes you can see flood because of rainfall patterns, erratic rainfall patterns, fluctuations in rainfall, all these are the signals or signs of land degradation. So in 1994, okay, UNCCD was established. And they give more importance to peoples in dry lands to maintain and restore the land and productivity, and also mitigate the drought. Mitigate means what? You're going to overcome. You're going to minimize. The severity of global warming can be minimized. See the barren area. This is the condition in Argentina. Okay. So global level desertification is analyzed by which body? UN Combat of Desertification or Conference on Desertification, where they estimated that about 3.97 billion hectares of land is under dry land. Okay, this is the main cause is the desertification. So many discussions on desertifications were going on even at global level for soil degradation. Okay, so water erosion, wind erosion, chemical degradation and physical degradations were also being categorized from this soil erosion. So 260 million hectares of rainfed cropland, 777 million of rangelands. Everything is being now in dry land condition. Okay, dry land areas. So these are some of the sources from there collected the proportion of dry land and the area affected by desertification. Okay. So there are many studies that has been put forward in 70s, 80s and even in 90s. 2000s also, you can see global database of desertification. So these all result make us aware about the vulnerable zones the population is going to face or are in the condition. Okay. So many organizations were developed in order to visualize this global land degradation systems. Okay, food and agriculture organizations, they also framed, okay, they also look after these problems from GIS mapping. Hope you know what is GIS mapping. So they look the problem, lack of observability of specific land degradation process using geo remote sensing imaging. Image, have you seen that imaging GIS? So remote sensing satellites are being available. See the condition of desertification using GIS. See the barren area. See the green area and the barren area. Here you can see satellite imaging of these particular area using GIS. Okay. So this gives us an idea how your country is or the world is in the threat of the certification. So that is understanding from here. So there is a fluctuation in the vegetative cover. Have you observed that? Okay, this images using this remote sensing will helps in making improvements, or you can give some suggestions based upon the spatial patterns. Okay, so remote sensing is a very good for analyzing the desertification patterns. So for regreening is necessary. Okay, regreening is necessary. For that, climatic interventions are playing an important role to overcome the situation. So for there is other organization like NDVI. So in that, inability to determine the vegetative species of the compound of the composition of an area. So what is the condition of desert shrub? Okay, that is the vegetative cover has been replaced by desert scrub because of desertification. Overgrazing also can result in desertification. Okay, so if you have a very reduced amount of fine fuels, and even our grassland is being converted to desert, so there is lower amount of biomass of grass. So people are behind this, how to combat the situation. There are high resolution remote sensing with satellite imaging techniques that helps to analyze this or monitor the environmental problems. So there are what is the condition? In situ, what is the condition? The spatial and temporal scales can be used by analyzed by using remote sensing data. So remote sensing data is a very important fact. Okay. So there are many methods by which you can combat this. First, using technical side, you can see that how it is being affected. Technical side using GIS, remote sensing. Okay, so vegetative degradation can be looked through this parameter also. So there are many alternative studies that is being carried out for soil sample analysis from 1987. Okay, look at the people behind, they are going behind all this. 1969, 1996. Many organization has been made. Okay, so land degradation, desertification is a part, isn't it? For land degradation, desertification is a part. So one part of land degradation is desertification. You can see many dry lands. The farmers are being affected because of the severe degradation. Okay, so farmers are being more affected because of this degradation. So analyze the condition. So you need to conserve it. You need to conserve this, conserve the soil as much as possible. For that, the agronomist, the soil scientist has to put forward lot of socio-economic policies against this exploitation. So that is a point that we have to discuss. Many policies are being framed in order to overcome the situation. I hope very few will be, anyway, everything will be under government view. Government are looking onto this particular aspect because the certification itself is a major issue we all are facing. So we need to combat this condition by adopting lot of strategies, conservation protocols, everything. So analysis whether you want this green or whether you want this muddy area. Okay. So these are the, so many intergovernment are making what drought management system, how to how to go back for how to go back to get that real world, how to combat this complete loss. So many from institutional policy level also there is many methods has been advocated. Even the organization, international level organization, international efforts has been taken to halt desertification so thereby we can achieve a sustainable development goals in dry areas, especially in dry areas. So in from science we have learned biological productivity, economic productivity, everything, but through desertification, if desertification is expanding, then it will be a threat, then it will be, it can cause very complicated systems. So we have to analyze the role of science in global desertification. We need to make a debate on it. How come the policies will be useful for eradicating this soil erosion, water erosion, salination and soil clustering? So we need to come out with some meaningful ideas on desertification. Land degradation. How come we could overcome the dry land population and what are the serious after effects of desertification? Okay, so this is the basic idea of a paper that is being published in a journal. Okay, so desertification is a very crucial point that we should analyze. Combating measures and protocols have to be done from Department of Physical Geography, Netherlands. Desertification, science versus political realities. So I hope this section will be useful in one or another way. We need to combat this desertification and we need to get proper land for more productivity. Thank you.